So moving to another theme, of course, is Back to the Future. It's such an iconic theme.
That was an interesting film for many, many reasons. Musically, one of the interesting things about Back to the Future was that Bob, in the making of that film, didn't have a lot of expansive, scopey shots. Oh, none, basically. Everything was close. Everything, you know, the whole clock tower event was in, you know, it was on a set in the center of a small town. Where were the big shots? There were none.
That's right, yeah.
So it was all very close kind of work. And yet, it's about great heroism, great friendship, great love, great adventure, but no real visual
Right.
panoramas,
Yeah.
certainly, you know, to give you that big vroom, desert shot, you know, looking off into infinity. None of that. So when I first met Bob, I met him while he was shooting the Enchantment Under the Sea dance at a church on Franklin Avenue in Hollywood. And he was in the midst of a lot. It was probably his biggest setup day in the making of the film. And so we're talking in the cracks, and he finally turns to me at one point and he goes, "It's got to be Big Al." And he's doing this with his hands, like over his head. And he's talking to everybody because he's directing 150 people, probably. But
Yeah.
it's then he'd come at Big. So I walked out with that kind of burned into the EEPROM.
Yeah.
It's got to be Big. It's got to be Big. So I went back, and it's a big story.
It is,
Again,
yeah.
like I, you know, was saying, high adventure, great love, great friendship. And that came out very quickly. I knew I needed something heroic. I knew it had to be able to be played big. I very often think in terms of a simple song.
Because you have to have that hook, right? There has to be.
Well, you have to have, very often, like a song, you have to have a verse and a chorus. You have to have a place where you tell the story, and then you have to have a place where you celebrate the story. And so, you know, Back to the Future, it's a very simple song form. It's an AABA song. You know, it's verse, verse, chorus, and you're there. You know, beam, bom, bom, ba-da-dee-da-da-dum, da-dum, bom, 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 beam, bom, ba-da-dum. Change key, same thing.
Yeah.
Bom, 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 ba-da-dee-da-da-dum, da-da-da-dum-dum-dum-dee-dum, da-da-dum. Great. But that's not where we raise our fist. We do it when bum ba-da-ding dum dum dum. Right? So it's a real simple concept. And it's a simple song form. If we're looking at something mysterious and we go bing bum 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 bum. It's the first bar of the theme, but it's now starting to travel score-wise through the movie. You know, when George picks Lorraine up and we use that little bit of the B section, da-da-dee, da-da-dee, da-da-dum, ba-dee-da-dee. We're playing it beautifully with strings, very slowly. It's not a big brassy heroic treatment of the theme. It's really soft, and the strings are carrying the weight of that. But it's like part of our fabric now, And so all the pieces of that theme, more so probably than just about any other film I've done, they're just embedded all through that film.
Yeah.
And they're always there kind of subliminally helping us to keep, you know, us in the moment
yeah, yeah.
of Back to the Future.
Absolutely.